Hello friends, my name is Dr. Puru Dhawan, and in this video we will talk about the protein loss in a kidney failure patient. Because in a kidney failure patient, when the person urinates, what happens? Because of presence of protein in the urine becomes frothy, and this froth denotes the health of your kidney. This is the first symptom which appears in almost all kidney failure patients before the rise of creatinine. So let's start how we can control the protein loss in a kidney failure patient and how we can control the level of creatinine in a kidney failure patient. Before moving towards the treatment for protein loss in a kidney failure patient, it's very important for us to understand why this happens, what goes wrong in a kidney failure patient. When a patient suffers from kidney failure because of high blood pressure or sugar level or IgA nephropathy, the membrane which is filtering each and everything in your body, which is the main functional unit of the body, which is known as nephron, is unable to keep the protein inside the body. Because of pressure of blood pressure and because of high sugar level, this membrane leaks protein, and when this leakage happens, this protein comes into urine and makes the urine frothy. So in a kidney failure patient, when we want to control the loss of protein, we have to go to the cause of the kidney failure. And in most cases, in the 40% cases, the cause of kidney failure is your high blood pressure. What happens in the high blood pressure is that when your blood pressure is high, this blood enters your the kidney with very high pressure. And because of this pressure, it causes strike to the wall of the thin membrane of the nephron. Because of constant strike of blood with the membrane, this membrane starts making changes in itself so that it can survive. During this mutation, during this changes, what happens? The membrane becomes sclerosed, membrane become thick, membrane become hard, and when this happens, it loses the function to filter out the blood. And as a function of that membrane goes, the level of the creatinine start increasing, the kidneys start losing protein from the body. So if we want to control the level of protein in a kidney failure patient, we have to control the level of blood pressure first. Without controlling blood pressure, we can't control the protein loss, we can't control the level of creatinine. So we have to take care of the root cause of the kidney failure if we want to manage that patient. Similar thing is happening in the case of diabetic nephropathy. Patient who suffer from chronic kidney disease because of diabetes, what happens? Because of this high sugar level in the blood, first the nephron cells become weak. Second thing, what happens? Our kidney work as a pressure valve for the sugar. If your sugar level increases above 200, what happens? Kidney open its gates for the sugar, and sugar starts moving out of the body through urine. So if this thing happens again and again on a daily basis, what happens? Because of this high workload to the kidney gradually stops, kidneys start losing its function. So if we want to control, same thing, if we want to control the diabetes, if we want to control the diabetic nephropathy, we have to control the diabetes. We have to make sure that the level of sugar is in the right amount. One more thing happens with the patient of diabetic nephropathy. Few drugs which are given as anti-diabetic drugs to the patient of diabetes, these drugs opens the gate of sugar forcefully so that the level of sugar can be controlled in the body even before the level reaches the 200. And when we process sugar from the body forcefully through the kidney, that damages the kidney, and as the damages happens, kidney loses its function, and as the function loses, the level of creatinine increases, the protein loss increases. So we have to take care of the diabetes first if we want to control the chronic kidney disease in a diabetic nephropathy cases. So these are the 80% cases. So the 40% patient of kidney failure is caused by high blood pressure, another 40% is caused by diabetes, and 10% is caused by IgA nephropathy, and another 10% is caused by polycystic kidney. IgA nephropathy and polycystic kidney both are genetic disorder. We will discuss this disorder in another later video. But if we want to control chronic kidney disease, if we want to control the protein in any kidney failure patient, we have to control the root cause of that problem, and that is either your high blood pressure, your sugar level, or your immunity. So we have to work on the root cause if we want to control the level of protein. Now, to control the level of creatinine and protein loss in a kidney failure patient, we have to start kidney function restoration treatment. In this treatment, what we do, step number one, we have to control the cause of the kidney failure. Once the cause of the kidney failure is in control, we can move on to step number two. In step number two, what we do with the help of Ayurvedic medicine, we increase the kidney's functions. And as the kidney function increases, the output of the creatinine, urea, potassium, and other electrolyte also increases. And as the output increases, the level of creatinine, urea drops in the body. So it's very important for us to increase the kidney function, because we all know once the nephrons are damaged, they remain damaged, but we can increase the function of the healthy nephrons. Now let's take an example. Suppose I have donated one kidney to somebody else. I have only one kidney left with me, but this kidney will perform all the functions properly. My level of creatinine bond increases, my level of urea bond increases, my level of potassium bond increases. The question arises, why? Because kidney has ability to increase its function according to the need. So we have to use this property of the kidney so that the remaining functioning part of the kidney can increase its function so that it can filter creatinine, urea, potassium with a great efficacy so that it can control the level of all other waste material easily. Now let's move to a step number three. Once the cause of the kidney failure is in control, the level of creatinine, urea is in control, the third step happens. Because of these favorable conditions inside the body, kidney starts making some kind of changes in itself. Kidney starts increasing its function, and as the function, natural functions of the kidney increases, now the body doesn't need any kind of medicine, any kind of support. Now kidney is self-capable of filtering out the all kind of waste material on its own. But in this KFRT treatment, diet plays a very important role. We consider diet as a 50% part of the diet, because with the help of diet, we can control lots of things in a kidney failure patient. We can control the level of creatinine, we can control the level of potassium. So it's very important for all kidney failure patients to understand what kind of diet they should take so that they can level of creatinine can be easily controlled. So let's start with the creatinine. Creatinine is a waste material which is produced in our muscles. And if we want to control the level of creatinine, we have to decrease the level of muscle metabolism. And when a patient of kidney failure take large amount of protein, this muscle metabolism increases, and as the results, the level of creatinine increases. So all the patient of science engineering suffering from kidney failure are advised to take low amount of protein, or they can take protein free diet if their body is strong enough. And when we put the patient on a low protein diet or protein free diet, what happens? Because of this, the level of formation of the creatinine decreases, and the level of creatinine also decreases in the body. But protein is the building block of the body. If we stop taking protein for a long time, our body deteriorates. So we can't do that. We have to take those protein which are easily absorbable, easily digestible, and they doesn't create any kind of creatinine in the body. So at Science Engineering, we advise all kidney failure patients to take moong ki dal without chilka, because this is the vegetarian source of protein which is very good, which is easily absorbable, which can easily assimilate, which doesn't contain any kind of creatinine in the body. So it's very important to stick to those things which we provide you, which we suggest you. So as we know that the creatinine is produced in the muscle, so we have to take care of the muscle metabolism. Suppose a patient of kidney failure do lots of exercises, lot kind of heavy exercises, weightlifting and all, what happens? Because of increased metabolism of the muscles, the level of creatinine increases. And if the patient suffers from any kind of fever or some kind of shivering happens because of some cold climate, the level of creatinine increases. So we have to take care of all these things. Now let's move to the potassium and see how we can control the level of potassium in a kidney failure patient. Potassium is present in each and everything whatever we eat, but few things contains potassium in naturally low amount and few things contain potassium in naturally in high amount. So we have to select those food items which contains potassium in low amount. So let's move to a vegetable and see how we can control the level of potassium in a body with the help of vegetables. Any vegetable which is grown below the surface of earth contains potassium in high amount, like potato, sweet potato, turnip, everything, anything, any vegetable which is grown below the surface of earth. Similarly, any vegetable which is leafy, like your mustard, spinach, coriander, mint, all these vegetables contain potassium in high amount. So we have to avoid all these vegetables. We have to avoid rooty and leafy vegetable. So now the question arises, what kind of vegetable we can eat? We have to take those vegetables which are what we can say which are grown as a fruit on a plant or a cucumber, like brinjal, tomato, bitter ground, round ground, pumpkin, any kind of vegetable which is grown on creeper or a plant as a fruit can be easily taken. So if you take these kind of vegetable, level of potassium will remain in a normal range, and you don't have to leash the vegetable, because lots of people come to me, lots of patients comes to me and they say, can we leash the vegetable? And I always suggest them to avoid leaching, because when we advise leaching to a patient, what happens, because of leaching, not only the potassium goes away, lots of vitamins, minerals, which is very much required by the body to heal the kidney, is also leached away. So we don't want to lose those vitamins and minerals. We have to provide those minerals and vitamins to the body. So avoid leaching. Try to select those food item which contains potassium in the low amount. Now let's move to the fruit and see how fruit can help a patient to control the level of potassium. In case of fruits, we have to avoid few fruits, and rest fruits can be easily given. We have to avoid banana, avocado, kiwi, and dry fruits, dates, and coconuts. These are the six items which has to be avoided in category of fruits. Rest fruits can be given. You can give papaya, you can give chiku, you can give apple, you can give grapes, any fruit you want, but the quantity size, portion size is very important. Don't cross the 1 cup portion size. Suppose you want to give strawberries, 1 cup. If you want to give apple, 1 apple. And if you want to give papaya, 1 cup of papaya. These portion size will limit the potassium content in the body. So in case of fruits, take care of the portion size. So let's move back to the creatinine and see what kind of food item has to be avoided if we want to control the creatinine level. To control the creatinine level, we have to avoid all kind of non-veg items. Non-veg items, especially like chicken, mutton, fish, lamb, dairy products like milk, custard, and curd, has to be avoided, because if we don't avoid these kind of things, the muscle metabolism will increase and the formation of creatinine will increase. Limit the amount of protein and type of protein to 1 bowl of moong ki dal. If you take 1 cup of 1 bowl of moong ki dal, the level of creatinine won't increase. It will remain stable, it will go down. And if we move to other pulses for source of protein, what may happen is that because the other pulses are hard to digest, they may create creatinine in the body. So we have to avoid pulses also, but exception is moong ki dal, and stick to this, the level won't increase in future. Now let's move back to the topic. If we want to control the level of protein loss, we have to take care of our kidney first. We have to stop the damage, and to stop the damage, we have to work on the cause of kidney failure. These are the simple basics of kidney failure, what we use at Science and Germany to control the level of creatinine, potassium, protein in a kidney failure patient. If you have any kind of question, query, you can simply ask on the number given below. You can also book an appointment with me on the same number, and you can also visit our website sciencekidneycare.com for further information. With this, allow me to say goodbye. See you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.